Lakers' opportunity to finally dethrone the Celtics would come in the 1969 finals, and an LA triumph seemed imminent. Russell, Boston's 35-year-old player coach, was in his final season, and the team had barely made the playoffs.
We all thought that we had the best team, the better team. We had the best record. We beat them during the season. We were the better team.
And West, knowing that this could be the Lakers' last and best chance to beat Boston, was playing the finest basketball of his life.
Jerry West, he had the best championship of any player that I've ever seen. That he averaged over 40 points a game against the Celtics. He was unstoppable because he wanted to win.
Despite the heroics of West, the Celtics were able to extend the series to a seventh game. But for the first time, it would be at the Forum in Los Angeles, where Jack Kent Cooke had planned a special celebration.
Jack Kent Cooke was the owner of the Lakers. He put out a sheet in all the seats. When the Lakers win the championship, the USC band would play Happy Days Are Here Again. The balloons in the rafters would fall down, and Chick Hearns would interview Elgin Baylor, Jerry West, and Wilt Chamberlain in that particular order.
But the Lakers fell behind early and were in even deeper trouble when Chamberlain left the game in the fourth quarter with an injured knee. He pleaded to re-enter the game, but Laker coach Butch Van Bredekop, who had feuded with Wilt all season, ignored his big man's pleas.
Van Bredekop refused to put him back into the game, and Jack Kent Cooke came down and told Van Bredekop to do it, and Van Bredekop turned around to the owner and expressed a very simple epithet to get out of there. It was madness.
Even with Wilt on the bench, L.A. fought back and pulled to within a point. The time running out, Boston's Don Nelson launched a shot that bounced high off the rim, just as Frank Selby's had 7 years earlier.
Erickson taps the ball to Nelson, whose shot bounces straight up and then straight through.
Don Nelson made a shot that I've never seen in all the years of basketball except that one time. I mean, it was absolutely extraordinary.
And the Celtics, they have done it again. A spectacular finish.
Jerry West was named the finals MVP after averaging more than 40 points a game, the only time a player on the losing team had won the award. But Russell and the Celtics walked off with yet another championship trophy. The Lakers were left to ponder their seventh finals defeat in 11 years at the hands of Boston.
No way should we have lost to Boston. Just no way. I mean, I still don't know how we lost to Boston. It's a mystery to me.
I think that was the toughest loss. I think that affected the players that had been there all the years more than anyone.
I can remember the champagne bottles popping in the dressing room next door, and the Celtics celebrating, and Jerry West, after everybody cleared, I was still sitting in his seat with his uniform on. He hadn't taken a shower. Everybody else was gone. He's still just sitting there. How it would eat at him because he's such a winner. But yet the world championship eluded him all these years.
I thought we should have won in 1969. I thought we had the better team. And those are the things that leave the emotional scars. Even to this day, it's like you can almost recall the ghost of the past. It doesn't feel very good.
The following season would bring more late-game heroics from West in the finals.
2 seconds, 1 second, West throws it up, he makes it! West threw it up and makes it!
But in the end, the Lakers' anguish would continue as they would once again lose in the seventh game, this time to the New York Knicks. When they were ushered out of the 1971 playoffs by Kareem Abdul-Jabbar's Milwaukee Bucks, it seemed the likely end of the championship dream for this group of Lakers. Chamberlain and West were both in the twilight of their careers, and Elgin Baylor would retire 8 games into the 1972 season. But the Lakers had made some crucial additions. Sharpshooting guard Gale Goodrich and former Celtic Bill Sharman, their new coach, whose presence seemed to spark something in the team's psyche.
He made us believe in ourselves. He made me believe in myself that we could do it one more time. And I'm looking at him like, is he crazy? How are we going to win with these guys right here?
It's probably one of the few times in my career I really felt that we were a team. Most of the time, our team comprised of Elgin Baylor and myself trying to score 35 or 50 every night. That's not the way to play basketball. And it was like a breakthrough for us. It was just a sense of one person playing the game.
Suddenly, everything seemed to click for the Lakers as they won an astonishing 33 straight games, the longest winning streak in the history of professional sports.
At last, you know, all of a sudden, things are happening our way. I mean, we were getting some of the good turns. We were getting some of the bounce of the ball. And so all of a sudden, you know, we became this team that was somewhat magical. And the more we won, the more magical we became.
It was that one opening in the clouds. This just seemed really easy to do. It seemed like we were destined to win.
After eight straight losses in the finals dating to 1959, the 72 Lakers would finally win an NBA championship, defeating New York in five games.
Goodrich passes under to Wilt. He puts it up and slams it.
The Lakers had not only ended more than a decade of frustration, they'd established themselves as one of the greatest teams in the history of the NBA.